Hello there, Capricorn, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Mary Sue, and today I am going to be doing your love reading for the first half of August. We'll take a look at the overall energies in your romantic love life, and then we'll get some details with the tarot. And if you're enjoying the content that I create or resonating with the message, I would really appreciate it if you would consider like, sharing, or subscribing. Okay, let's get into your reading. We're going to first take a look at the overall energies. Let's see what we have here. What are your overall energies? Come to the edge. It's like needing to take a risk with a certain relationship, or, and we have TikTok. So TikTok, you know, time is running out, that type of energy. But it's like you have to take a risk. You have to, I'm getting the sense that you may need to, you know, go ahead and you know, put yourself out there, be vulnerable with somebody that, you know, they are wanting that with you, and that this is your opportunity. Or, if, you know, even if there's like somebody that, you know, you're kind of like friendly with or something, but you're feeling more romantically inclined with this person. It's about going ahead and taking the risk. Like the time is good. TikTok is like divine timing. Timing is running out. Like you have a window of opportunity here. And then on the bottom is all that glitters. So all that glitters is talking about, you know, like things that appear to be one way, but that they really aren't. It's like fool's gold. So we'll see what that's about. And no place like home, and not for you. So there could be, you know, somebody that you're in a connection with. They may be taking the risk. Or you could be separated from this person and they're coming back. So, we're definitely going to look at the details about this. But with this, it's as if the person that you are thinking about is not who you really think they are. Okay, so we'll take a look at that. You know, you don't want to you don't want to go to the edge with somebody that's not the one for you. That's for sure. Okay, let's take a look at your present energy, Fool. Yeah, you know, this is very much this, you know, like wanting to go on a new path, having a new path opening up for you. Realizing that there's a new direction that you need to go in. It could also be that if you have met somebody recently and you're like, ooh, kind of interested, but not sure, they may be a little edgy, come to the edge, a little bit edgier than you're used to or something. A little more daring, a little bit more risky because, you know, Capricorn, you like to follow the rules and everything, right? It could be somebody that is a little bit more edgier than you are used to dating or being with. And it's about kind of like stepping into that energy of, ooh, I think I might go for that, you know, like do something different. Okay, so let's see what your obstacle or what is in resistance here. Three of Cups. Okay, I have to say it, Capricorn, because it's showing up in your resistance. This could be a third-party situation. But it's also that you're not celebrating it, okay? So we're going to look at the, you know, get some more details about this. So since this is your obstacle, this could be a third-party situation. And maybe, Capricorn, you know, you're kind of like, well, I kind of know that they're kind of with somebody else, or, well, I think, you know, they were married or they are married, but, you know, they're getting ready to separate or something like that. And you're kind of like, oh, you know, I really like this person. I've never done anything like that before. Maybe I'll try something like that because you have the all that glitters. This is kind of bothering me because I feel like you may be wanting to go on a new path with somebody that is very different than what you normally are accustomed to being with, but at the same time, you may not recognize the fact that the way that they are perceiving or telling you the situation is not for real. And especially like no place like home, as if, you know, their home life, I'm getting the idea that, you know, their home life is not the way that they are portraying it. you know, whatever that may mean. You know, they may be saying, oh, well, you know, my significant other, my partner, my spouse doesn't get me or something like that. Or be saying, oh, I'm, you know, moving out or something like that. And then you figure out, they weren't, you know, that really wasn't as true as you thought. Okay, so let's see what the outcome is. Capricorn, you, I'm intrigued. What is going on here? Two of Swords. Yeah, you have a decision to make. Okay, Capricorn, on the bottom, Seven of Cups. Either this person or you has other options and could be confused about that. You're wanting to have victory in this. You want to put your time and effort into it. It's kind of like you really want this to work out, but it's interesting. I'm not sure what the other person is thinking. That's what we got to figure out, right? Is, you know, you may be saying, well, maybe this is just, you know, for fun. Maybe I'll just be with this person for a little while. Maybe we'll just have some fun together or something like that. And you've never, you know, done something like, you know, not that you haven't kind of like casually dated before, but it's kind of like, this is like, yeah, I know that this is not going to work out, but that's okay. I just want to go and have fun with this. So let's take a look at this Fool card. We have the Moon, the Tower, the Emperor. Okay, four major arcana in your present moment with the Knight of Wands on the bottom. Capricorn, I can only deliver the message that I'm getting here, that this person that you're dealing with is a Knight of Wands. You know, this is the player energy. And, you know, I think that they may want to come in and try to, they may have played you in the past and be trying to come back in and heal the situation. But you're showing up as a Queen of Pentacles. That is so different than a Knight of Wands, okay? That means that you are the catch, Capricorn. You're the big catch. And this person is possibly trying to take advantage of you. And with this, all that glitters, I'm also getting like this person may be trying to take advantage of you financially. So I'm just going to throw that out there. Be careful with that. Okay, so with the Fool card, this is, you know, an energy of going on a new path, trying something new, going in a new direction. Now, if you're separated from this Knight of Wands, you may be saying, yeah, I'm going on a new path. I'm getting away from the Knight of Wands, right? But if this is a brand new person that you have recently started dating or thinking of starting to date, and you're getting a couple of red flags that this person could be a Knight of Wands, there is something that you need to know. This person has secrets, and I feel like they are very controlling with the Emperor energy and the Moon. The Moon is talking about secrets, and the Emperor talks about controlling, wanting things their way, maybe kind of telling you one thing, but you know, the Emperor to me has some manipulation in it. You know, and especially with the Moon card, you do not know this whole picture. You do not know this whole picture. And with the Tower, it's kind of like almost, I feel like you're, you know, this is not going to resonate with everybody, but I feel like for some of you, you're being warned that, you know, this is a person that you do not need to be around. And once again, you know, take it as it resonates. If this is not resonating with you at all, you might want to check out your Moon, Rising, or Venus sign. But for somebody, this is a clear message that you're with somebody that, you know, is on your path for a certain reason with this TikTok. Because the Moon card also shows that it's kind of like divinely guided. Like this person is on your path perhaps for you to learn a certain lesson. You may need to learn like how to detect red flags in a situation or something. Okay, with the Three of Cups, we have the Strength card. We have the Three of Pentacles and the Nine of Pentacles with the King of Cups on the bottom. I think this person is honestly a Knight of Wands, but they're coming in and acting as if they're a King of Cups, you know, that they're all lovey-dovey and, you know, going to, you know, try to, you know, bring all this love into your life, right? But it is a little bit of, you know, a manipulation, because I mean, with two threes in your obstacle, I don't usually go with the third party situation, because, you know, the third party can be a lot of different things. It may be another person, but it could be, you know, they're really attached to their job or to a certain hobby or interest that takes a lot of their time. It does not have to be another person, but I really am getting a sense that there is something that you don't know about this person, and there is a good chance that this person could, you know, be putting you into a third party situation without you knowing it, because the Three of Pentacles and the Three of Cups is kind of a signifying that, you know, you need to have the strength to keep your independence in the situation. And once again, I would be, you know, it's, I'm not going to say everybody has free will, so you can do what you want to, Capricorn, but I would tread carefully in this situation. I would tread really carefully. Go slow. Go slow. You know, the TikTok is here. You may be thinking, you know, this person may be pressuring you into something. And especially, I mean, this just keeps coming up in, you know, it just keeps catching my eye, which is kind of a, you know, a message from my angels that there's something here. They could be pressuring you into giving them money. You know, they may be saying, oh, I'm starting this new business, I need some seed money, or I'm trying to buy this house because we have no place like home. Or I'm selling my house. I sold my house and I'm trying to buy another house, but I haven't closed on it yet. You know, there's like some big story that they need to borrow some money to close on a house or something like that. There's something, I think, here with money. And I think that they're kind of pressuring you. If you have money, Capricorn, and somebody is kind of like trying to pressure you in a romantic connection, you know, to maybe buy a home with them, right? Or to start a business with them or something, because underneath that is not for you. And under that is a change in the wind. And under that is round and round. So it's like, you know, this could be a pattern. This person may be coming on your path because this is maybe a pattern that you've seen in your relationships. And it doesn't have to be just romantic. It could be family and friends that are always asking you for money, or, you know, money seems to be the basis of some of your relationships or something like that. And this person is, you know, on your path with the Knight of Wands, like they're going to be here today, gone tomorrow. Like this person comes in, they teach you this lesson, and then they move on. And with this the four major arcana in your present position, it's like happening now. It's like happening now. I have a feeling this person is in your life right now or will be in your life very soon. Okay, so with the Two of Swords, we have the Death card, the Knight of Wands, and the Queen of Pentacles. Now, on the bottom, we have Six of Wands. Capricorn, I'm glad to see this. It means you're going to have victory in this situation. Ace of Wands, you're going to get some information, some idea about starting a fresh start, because this is, there's a lot of pain. And then look at this with the Three of Cups again. I would have to say that this person, there's something that you don't know about this person. Either they're married, or there's some other person or situation or job or financial difficulty. There's something in their life that they're not telling you about that is really important for you to know. And they're not going to tell you. I just really don't. Now, I'm going to say these two cards were on the bottom in the underneath earlier in this reading, and I've shuffled. Okay, and they're coming out again. See, this is what concerns me. You have the Knight of Wands and the Queen of Pentacles. Capricorn, you are pentacle energy, right? You're earth energy. So this Queen of Pentacles represents you. Now, think about that. This Knight of Wands is all about, you know, getting what they want and being very manipulative about it. And look at, you know, if you're a queen and you know, the Queen of Pentacles, that's why I keep thinking, you know, there's something about money here. You know, you may not have like a ton of money, but it's kind of like they may be saying, oh, let's take some money out of your 403 or 404. Whatever that is, right? Let's take some money out of your investments. Let's take some money out of your house, your equity in your home or something. Like, they're looking at you as somebody that has a lot of money. And the Queen of Pentacles is also known as the best catch, romantic catch in the deck. Because the Queen of Pentacles and gender doesn't matter here. It's just this energy of you have everything and you're also nurturing. Like, the Queen of Pentacles is a better catch than any king, because the kings are kind of like masters, right? And the Queen of Pentacles still has a lot of love. Look at, she's holding a baby, right? She has everything. And then this person that you're dealing with is a player, okay? They only have something in mind that they want from you, okay? And they're coming in and they may be acting like they're a lot of gold, right? Oh, I'm the real thing. I'm your king to your queen, but they're not. And, you know, with the Death card here, it means that your decision is about how to end or if to end, right? Because your outcome is this decision. And then with the Death card, there's something here that needs to end. Whether it's this relationship or a part of this relationship or whatever that resonates, for however that resonates for you. Well, Capricorn, I'm so sorry. This is a hard message to deliver, but I really, you know, it's not even like wishy-washy. It's really as if spirit is speaking to you and saying, watch it. You know, be really, really careful here. Okay, let's take a look at the soulmate cards. Let's see what we have here. We have travel, stuck, destruction, and family on the bottom. So, you know, once again, this person that you're dealing with, they could have a family because we also have no place like home. If you're married to this person, then, you know, think of that. they may have, you know, a third party. So again, it doesn't have to be a person, but there's something. They may be trying to, you know, finagle your finances. They may be, I don't know, they may be trying to, I hate to say things like this. They may be trying to leave your relationship, and they may be finagling your finances somehow, you know, hiding money or trying to pull out money or move money around, something like that. With travel, this person may be at a distance from you. They may want you, like if you met them online and they're asking you to come visit them, or they want to come visit you, okay? Something like that, or they may want to take a trip with you. But there's stuck energy here. There's something stuck, block, third party. Silence, barrier, shift your focus to clear the energy. Yeah, Capricorn, I really think that there's a third party here. And then we have destruction, tower moment, unexpected change, new opportunities. There's the thing to know. And you know, that is one thing, that is that, you know, you have two tower cards here. Remember, the universe is always looking out for you. You may feel like you're about to fall off the edge, like your whole world may be rocking right now. You know, especially if you have had inklings or red flags popping up, right? And then you see this reading and you're like, yeah, I think, that I'm connecting, intuitively to this reading. You may be kind of like feeling, oh my goodness, my world is falling away from me, right? You're on the edge of your world just crumbling. If you look at it, it says come to the edge, but to me it's also like the piece of earth that she's standing on is like crumbling underneath her. Like your world is, it's just falling away from you, what you have known. And you could be in a, this really kind of a tower moment right now. And one thing to keep in mind when you're going through a tower moment is that the universe comes in and takes things away from us when it knows, when the universe knows that there's something better for you. And that's really hard sometimes to remember when you're going through a tower moment, and I've been there, right? But it's also at the same time, it's kind of like they know that what you have right now is not real. It's not authentic. It's not for you. It's not for you. It's not for you. There is something better out there for you. And the universe is just trying to help you to get unstuck from this person. You may actually feel like you're stuck with this person. You could be sitting there going, yeah, I don't have any money. That's why I'm stuck in this, relationship, this marriage. I have these kids. I can't go anywhere. But you also have to realize that there's things that you don't know that are also going on. Okay, let's take a look at your creativity oracle card because there might be something there. Push. Don't feel inadequate. Forget how to quit. Push on. No matter how things look, I love that message for you, Capricorn, because I think that you are realizing there is a big change coming into your life. You have the tower twice, you have a change in the wind, you're coming to the edge. You may feel right now like you're in this kind of a desperate type of situation. Like, once again, your world is falling away from you, but it's about don't quit. It's You may need to quit this relationship, but it's like, don't quit on you. Capricorn, you got better things coming your way. And it's kind of like the universe is just saying, it's okay. Like your angels, your spirit guides, your deceased loved ones, your family, your friends, they're there for you. And it's like, it's going to be okay. You're making the right decision. If you're starting to see the signs and you're like, yeah, I got to get out of this situation, it's okay because there's something better in the future for you. The universe doesn't take things away from you that need to stay with you, right? It only takes away things that it knows are no longer meeting your best good, right? Your highest good takes those things away so that something better can come in. Yeah, this person has, I think there is a ro lot of romantic feelings here, especially with that Knight of Wands. I think that this person is very good at the passion part of your relationship. And then, oh, finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. Yeah, I really get the sense that there's something about money that you don't know. That moon card and then all of this finances stuff, there's something you don't know. And let your friends help you. Yeah, I mean, I really do. I feel like, it is a time that you need to reach out to your family and friends and get some help, get some support. And, maybe, if you're sitting there and going, well, yeah, but I think, things are going to be okay with this person. At least get some other advice, reach out to your friends and stuff and say, hey, what do you think about me doing this? And see what they say. Okay, now here's your lover's oracle card and Capricorn. If you have been resonating with this, I would really love to hear it in the comments. What your story is. I really am reaching out, giving you a big hug because I know that you know, this is possibly a really difficult situation that you're going through. So let's take a look at your lover's oracle card. Forgiveness. Stop focusing your energy on past events, for life is too precious to waste. You create your reality by what you think, dream, and imagine. And, you know, sometimes, especially if this person, you know, like some of this has already gone down, and perhaps this person has, you know, kind of pressured you into loaning them money or something like that. And it's kind of like, with this forgiveness, it's not you. Okay, there's always the step of forgiving the person that has bamboozled you, perhaps. But it's also about forgiving yourself, you know, for being in that position of not looking at the red flags or whatever that may mean for you. Forgiving yourself and then forgiving this person doesn't mean you have to forget. Forgiving, it doesn't mean that you condone it, but that's the only way you can heal, you know, the pain in this situation and move on. And I do want to remind you, you have the Six of Wands on the bottom. You are going to have victory in this situation. You know, stay with it. Push on, right? You have to push on. Don't quit. Push on. All right, Capricorn, I am going to leave it there. I do wish you lots of love and light in this situation and all your situations. Bye for now.